Good morning to everyone. Welcome to the series of the lecture. So in my previous lecture, we had completed some of the problems on the differentiation. Today onwards, we will go for the continuation of the differentiation to the next level, that is level number 3. I think all of you complete these problems, whatever I gave in the previous lecture. So once again, I have to recap that one problem. So for easy understanding the purpose, after that we'll go for the next level. Okay. Now here, so I want to explain the concept of a minus b cos x by a plus b cos x. So f of x is equal to f of x is equal to a minus b cos x by a plus b cos x. Just only for the recapitulation purpose, I had to explain this last problem. After that, we will go for the next problem. Okay. So differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Then d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of a minus b cos x by a plus b cos x. That is, d by dx of f of x means, that is, f dash of x is equal to, you will be formula had to apply for applying the derivative, that is a plus b cos x into d by dx of a minus b cos x, start from the denominator, minus again a minus b cos x into d by dx of a plus b cos x by a plus b cos x by a plus b cos x whole square, a plus b cos x whole square. So here, how to perform the derivative of a is to be the constant 0, and the d by dx of minus of b cos x is, that is, you have to bring that constant b into the in front of the derivative, then d by dx of cos x means, that is, sin x. Therefore, here, what I have to return this one as, f dash of x is equal to a plus b cos x into d by dx of a minus b cos x. The constant derivative is 0 and cos x derivative is minus of sin x, then plus b into sin x minus, now a minus b cos x into d by dx of a plus b cos x. The derivative of a is 0 and b cos x derivative is minus of b sin x. So this is minus of b sin x by a plus b cos x whole square. Now I have to simplify this. This is equal to, so ab into sin x, that is, I have to multiply these two terms, plus so b square into sin x into cos x. Again, minus of minus plus ab into sin x. Next one, this is minus of b square into sin x into cos x. Here minus of minus plus, and after minus is there, then that is equal to minus of b square into sin x by cos x by, so a plus b cos x whole square. Here plus b square sin x into cos x minus b square into sin x into cos x, both are to be cancelled. That is equal to ab sin x plus ab sin x means, that is 2ab sin x by, this is a plus b cos x whole square. All of you catch your point? likewise that may be obtained. So with that, whatever the knowledge you had acquired, so you'll go for the highest level. So the next level is, so you have to perform at a time the partial derivative of u by v and u v. So here there are some examples are there. You have to do that, problems has to be practiced. Here I had explained. So this one, first one and fourth one I had explained. The remaining problems you can do as to be practiced. Okay. Now coming to the next one. So let us take simultaneously you can apply the UV rule and U by V rule. At a time you have to apply. Okay. Let's see this. Now, so the first one is x into e power x by so 1 plus tan x. So this is f of x into e power x by 1 plus tan x into e power x by 1 plus tan x. Now here, so x is the algebraic function and e power x as the exponential function. Had to assume this one has to be u by v. This one has to be u and this one has to be v. Therefore, the formula for u by v is d by dx of u by v is equal to v into du by dx minus u into dv by dx by v square. Let me catch my point. So here I have to apply the formula here. Then this is equal to, so d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of so x into e power x by 1 plus tan x into e power x by 1 plus tan x, start from the denominator. So this is f dash of x. Okay, now so start from the denominator, 1 plus tan x into d by dx of x into e power x minus, so x into e power x into d by dx of 1 plus tan x by, so 1 plus tan x whole square. Now here that is equal to 1 plus tan x into here x into e power x is there. X is the algebraic function and e power x as the exponential function. While you have to perform the derivative of the product of those two functions, you can apply the UV rule. In this problem, what you have to observe? So both the U by V rule and UV rule simultaneously can apply in a single problem only. Okay, please all of you observe this. Here, so x into d by dx of e power x plus e power x into d by dx of x. The part is to be over. Minus of x into e power x into what is the derivative of 1? D by dx of 1 is 0. And d by dx of tan x. What is the derivative of tan x? So d by dx of tan x is secant square x. This is d by dx of tan x is equal to, so secant square x only. All of you catch my point? Now by so 1 plus tan x whole square. Now this is equal to, so 1 plus tan x into d by dx of e power x means that is e power x into x, that is x into e power x plus d by dx of x is 1 into e power x is, that is e power x. Next, minus of x into e power x into secant square x by so 1 plus tan x whole square. So there is no need to simplify this, because here this is tan x is there, and in that secant square x is there. We cannot cancel the terms. That is why. So whatever the derivative part is to be over, you have to left that problem. Okay. So in that similar way, you can do the second one also. So simultaneously apply U by V rule along with UV rule also. And also the third problem is x cube plus 2 by x square minus x minus 2. That is U by V formula you have to apply. And I had explained the fourth problem. Okay. So fourth one, please all of you note down the problem. So fourth one, here f of x is equal to, here f of x is equal to fourth one, f of x is equal to sin x plus cos x by square root of 1 plus sin 2x. Clarification point. So we can solve this problem simply by using the common sense. So first of all, you have to do the problem as it is. So after that, I can explain the shortcut method also. Please see this. Differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Therefore, d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of, so sin x plus cos x by root of 1 plus sin 2x. All of you catch your point. Now this is equal to, so u by v formula to apply, that is root of 1 plus sin 2x into d by dx of root of 1 plus sin 2x into next d by dx of sin x plus cos x minus sin x plus cos x into d by dx of root of 1 plus sin 2x by root of 1 plus sin 2x whole square. Let me catch your point. Now here I would apply root of 1 plus sin 2x. So f dash of x is equal to root of 1 plus sin 2x into d by dx of sin x plus cos x. Sin x derivative is cos x minus cos x derivative is sin x. Cos x minus sin x. Next minus of sin x plus cos x. Minus of sin x plus cos x into d by dx of root x. So here please all of you observe this. D by dx of root x means, how we have to write? That is d by dx of x power 1 by 2. Then this is in the form of x power n formula. So n into x power n minus 1. That is equal to 1 by 2 into x power 1 by 2 minus 1. That equal to 1 by 2 into x power minus 1 by 2. That is equal to 1 by 2 root x. This is the formula for d by dx of root x is equal to 1 by 2 root x. All of you please keep in your mind. So here this is sin x plus cos x into, first of all I had to perform the derivative of root x. After that the internal derivative I had to apply. So please see this. So this is d by dx of root x. That means 1 by 2 root of 1 plus sin 2x into d by dx of internal derivative, that is 1 plus sin 2x by 1 plus sin 2x by 1 plus sin 2x by, now here what do I have to write? So this is square root, both are to be cancelled, that is equal to 1 plus sin 2x. 1 plus sin 2x. 1 plus sin 2x. Now, so this is equal to, now you have to multiply. So the derivative part you have to apply here, that is equal to root of 1 plus sin 2x. So into cos x minus sin x, cos x minus sin x minus of sin x plus cos x minus of sin x plus cos x into, so 1 by 2 root of 1 plus sin 2x into d by dx of 1, that is 0. So next one, sin 2x derivative is 2 cos 2x into 2. Or simply you have to take, so cos, sin 2x derivative is cos 2x and the 2x derivative is to be 2. Therefore 2 cos 2x by so 1 plus sin 2x. 1 plus sin 2x. All of you understood this. So therefore this is the total part is to be over. This is the total part is to be over. So now, so the same problem can apply. The same problem you have to apply by using the shortcut method. After simplification, we will get the answer. There is no problem at all. So here, so for this problem, how you have to write the simplest method. So please see this. Then, so again I have to take the fourth problem. So sin x plus cos x, this is f of x is equal to sin x plus cos x by square root of 1 plus sin 2x. Simply I have to use the shortcut method. Okay, how do I write? Please all of you see this. So this is sin x plus cos x by, so in place of 1, in the trigonometry that already have to learn, the trigonometric equations, so that is sin square x plus cos square x equal to 1. Therefore this is sin square x plus cos square x plus sin 2x ki, in terms of the sin formula is, that is 2 sin x into cos x. All of you catch your point. These formulas you have to learn in the trigonometry second unit. Therefore this is sin square x plus cos square x is equal to 1 and sin 2x is equal to 2 sin x into cos x. 2 sin x into cos x. These two formulas you have to learn in the previous, had to apply here. Now please all of you see this. So sin x plus cos x by, then this is in the form of, this is in the form of a square plus b square plus 2ab. Then you have to apply the formula for, that is a plus b whole square. That means sin x plus cos x whole square. All of you catch your point. How I have to write this? Have you know this? A square plus b square plus 2ab means I have to write in this one as sin x plus cos x whole square. Here square root both are to be cancelled. Therefore you will get sin x plus cos x by, so sin x plus cos x. So then both are to be cancelled, then the function value is to be 1. Simply I have to use the common sense. Therefore here what the function that may be occurs here, f of x is equal to 1. Now we want it to derivative. Therefore d by dx of f of x is d by dx of 1. 1 means that is the constant. What the constant derivative is? 0. Then the derivative of this function is f dash of x is equal to 0. All of you catch your point. This is the shortcut method. Okay, likewise you have to simplify this total solution, then automatically you will get this value for f dash of x value is to be 0. All of you catch your point. Now in that similar way do the next one. The fifth one is log x by 1 minus log x. So log x by 1 minus log x. Here f of x is equal to log x by 1 minus log x. Log x by 1 minus log x. Therefore, so differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Differentiate with respect to x on both sides. That means d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of log x by 1 minus log x. Log x by 1 minus log x. Here also you can apply the u by v rule. Therefore 1 minus log x into, start from the v, into d by dx of log x minus of log x into d by dx of 1 minus log x by 1 minus log x whole square. 1 minus log x whole square. Then this is equal to 1 minus log x into d by dx of log x is What the derivative of log x? 1 by x minus log x into d by dx of 1, that is 0. Next one, log x derivative is again 1 by x. That is minus symbol is there, that is minus of 1 by x by minus of 1 by x by, so 1 minus log x whole square. 1 minus log x whole square. Now we have to multiply the fraction, that is, so here I have to multiply to 1 by x. Therefore, this is 1 by x minus of 1 by x into log x plus 1 by x into log x by, so 1 minus log x whole square. Here plus 1 by x log x minus 1 by log 1 by x log x, both are to be cancelled. That is equal to 1 by x by 1 minus log x whole square. This is the derivative of the function f dash of x is equal to 1 by x by 1 minus log x whole square. All of you understood this? In this level, what you have to learn? Simultaneously, you can apply the u by v rule along with uv rule, or also apply in a single problem. Okay. So, like that, you may be complete the problems that may be available in, so 6th, 7th, 8th and 9th problems. Okay. Please, all of you do that one, has to be practiced in the next class onwards. Next, coming to the next level. So, level 5. So, here f of x is equal to, here f of x is equal to e power x into x power 4. So, the, I think all these problems are to be so completed in the level 2 and the level 1 also. Again, you have to recapitulate that one. So, here f of x is equal to, first problem, e power x into x power 4. E power x into x power 4. So, differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Therefore, d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of, so e power x into x power 4 only. E power x into x power 4 only. Therefore, the formula that you have to learn, so simultaneously you can apply the product of the two functions. That is d by dx of uv is equal to u into dv by dx plus v into du by dx. Clarification point. So then this is e power x into d by dx of x power 4 plus x power 4 into d by dx of e power x. Therefore, that is equal to e power x into x power 4 derivative is 4 into x cube plus x power 4 into e power x derivative is to be e power x. Therefore, take e power x has to be common in both the two terms. Therefore, e power x into this is 4x cube plus x to the power of 4. This is f dash of x only. F dash of x only. Okay. This is the competency that may be arises while solving the problems. Please, all of you observe this. Have to be able to solve. So, I think you may be easily solve 2nd, 3rd, 4th onwards. So, I'd explain the 5th and the 9th. After that, we'll go for the next level. Okay, now. So, coming to the 5th problem. Coming to the 5th sum. 5th sum. So, here f of x is equal to x square into e power x into sin x. X square into e power x into sin x. There are three functions are to be available in our given function. Therefore, while performing the derivative, that already have to use the formula d by dx of uvw is equal to so vw into du by dx plus, so next one, so uw into dv by dx plus next one uv into, so dw by dx. So here at a time, so there are the three functions are to be available in your given function. So I'll perform the derivative, had to apply this formula directly. Okay, now here, so differentiate differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Therefore, d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of x square into e power x into sin x. Then had applied the formula here. So this is e power x into sin x into d by dx of x square plus u into w x square into sin x into d by dx of e power x plus next one uv x square into e power x into d by dx of sin x. Now this is equal to e power x into sin x into d by dx of x square is, that is 2x, plus x square into sin x into e power x derivative is again e power x, plus now x square into e power x into sin x derivative is, that is cos x. Likewise, you have to complete the derivative of the function that having the three different functions are to be available in our given problem. Okay, so like that you may be complete. So 8th one I had explained. After that, the remaining problems you can do as to be practice. Okay, please all of you note on the right. Eighth one. So cubed root of. So here f of x is equal to cubed root of x to the power of 5 into e power x into log x. In that function that having algebraic function, exponential and the logarithm function. How I do write this one has to be x power 5 whole to the power of 1/3. Because this is the cubed root, then we can write it as 1/3. So into e power x into log x. Then this is in the form of. So x power n whole to the power of m formula. So that is x power 5/3 into e power x into log x. D power x into log x. Therefore, differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Therefore, this is d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of x power 5/3 into e power x into log x. X power 5/3 into e power x into log x. Therefore, so here, so e power x into log x into d by dx of uvw, had applied the formula f dash of x is equal to, so d by dx of x to the power of 5/3 plus next one, so x to the power of 5/3 into log x into d by dx of e power x plus x power 5/3 into e power x into d by dx of log x. And now, so what is the formula for d by dx of x power n is equal to, so n into x power n minus 1, that already we have to learn. So now d by dx of, this is the fractional value that may be occurs, x power 5/3 is equal to 5/3 into x power 5/3 minus 1, that is equal to 5/3 into x to the power of 2/3. Love you, catch your point. Now in place of this I have to write e power x into log x into e power x into log x into, so 5/3 into x to the power of 2/3 plus, now what is the derivative of e power x? E power x derivative is again e power x. Therefore x power 5/3 into log x into, so e power x plus, again log x derivative is 1/x. Therefore x to the power of 5/3 into e power x into 1/x. So likewise, have to complete the derivative whether the given function that having the three in different functions are to be available. Okay, like that, please all of you complete the remaining problems that already you cannot discuss the problems. Okay, now coming to the next level. So this is level 6. This is the level 6. So here, this is called the chain rule of the differentiation. This is the very, very competency while we have to perform the derivative. Please all of you see this. So first note one is, if u is a function of x and y and y is a function of u, then dy by dx is equal to, suppose u is a function of x and y is a function of u, then so we have to perform the derivative with respect to x of y, then dy by du into du by dx. Simply we have to cancelize the du du terms, then we will get dy by dx here. So this dy by dx I have to written as dy by dx I have to written as so dy by du into du by dx. In the similar way, so if y is the function of the u and u is the function of v and v is the function of the x, then I have to perform the derivative of y with respect to x, that is dy by du into du by dv into dv by dx. So likewise, this rule is called as the chain rule of the differentiation. So this is the very very competency while we have to perform the derivative. Please all of you be careful about these problems. Okay, now so coming to the first problem, so that is sine of 3x. Here f of x is equal to sine of 3x. Now here whatever the function is to be, had to assume this 3x has to be x while you had to perform the derivative of y with respect to x. Okay, so differentiate with respect to x on both sides. That means this can be written as directly f dash of x is equal to d by dx of sine 3x. Let me catch your point. Now what is the derivative of sine 3x? While you have to perform the derivative with respect to x of the sine function, had assumed 3x has to be x only, but we can write it as to be 3x. Had assumed that one has to be x. Please all of you keep in your mind. So sine 3x, the derivative of sine 3x is cos 3x, now into d by dx of 3x. This is called the internal derivative. Here what we have to done, so we will required for df by dx, so that is equal to, first of all we have to perform the derivative of the sine function. After that, again the sine function we have to perform the derivative with respect to x only. Now this is equal to, so cos 3x into what the derivative of 3x, that is 3. Therefore this is equal to 3 cos 3x. This is called the internal derivative. Now so coming to the next problem, please you can explain. So the second one, cos of 4x. So here f of x is equal to cos of 4x. Therefore differentiate with respect to x on both sides. That means f dash of x is equal to d by dx of cos of 4x. So now this is a cos function. I have to assume this one has to be cos x only. D by dx of cos x is minus of sine of 4x into d by dx of 4x. Now this is equal to minus of sine of 4x into d by dx of 4x, means that is to be 4. Therefore the total value is to be minus of 4 into sine of 4x. This is called the chain rule of the partial differentiation. Please all of you see this. So what he did, so here we had to perform the derivative of the total function cos x, then that is sine of 4x, minus of sine of 4x, and the internal derivative is what here I did, du by dx. That means whatever I had assumed the function is to be x, that function I had to perform the derivative with respect to x only. Let me catch my point. Now in that similar way, had to do the third one. So secant of f of x is equal to secant of x plus 1 by x. So while you have to assume this total function has to be x only, please all of you keep in your mind. So differentiate with respect to x on both sides. That means d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of secant of x plus 1 by x. Then this is what the derivative of f of x, that is f dash of x only. Now I assume this one has to be x. Secant x derivative is secant x into tan x. Therefore, this is secant of x plus 1 by x into tan of x plus 1 by x. So this is the derivative part of this function only, secant x function only. Now I have to perform the derivative, that is called the internal derivative. So into d by dx of x plus 1 by x. D by dx of x plus 1 by x. Then this is equal to, so secant of x plus 1 by x into, so tan of x plus 1 by x into, now d by dx of x. D by dx of x value is to be 1. And so d by dx of x value is to be minus of 1 by x square. Minus of 1 by x square, that already had to study about. That is d by dx of 1 by x, had kept this one as to be the numerator. So that is d by dx of x to the power of minus 1. Then this is equal to minus 1 into x to the power of minus 1 minus 1, that equal to minus 1 into x to the power of minus 2, that equal to minus of 1 by x square. This is the derivative of, so 1 by x. Now this is equal to, so secant of x plus 1 by x into, so tan of x plus 1 by x, tan of x plus 1 by x into 1 minus of 1 by x square. 1 minus of 1 by x square. This is the internal derivative. All of you understood this. Now, coming to the, so remaining, I think the 4 and 5 can easily solve the problems. 4 and 5 and 6 also. Now, so I will go for 7th one. I will go for the 7th one. So then this is 7th one is, here f of x is equal to cos to the power of 4x. F of x is equal to cos to the power of 4x. Now, so differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Therefore, d by dx of f of x is equal to, d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of cos to the power of 4x. Then this is f dash of x is equal to, so I have to assume this one has to be x to the power of n. That means cos x to the power of 4. Then what is the derivative of cos x? X power n, n into x power n minus 1. Then that is 4 into cos to the power of 4 minus 1 of x. So into the internal derivative is d by dx of cos x. D by dx of cos x. Therefore, this is equal to, so 4 into, that is cos cube x, into d by dx of cos x is, that is minus of sin x. That means this is equal to minus of 4 into sin x into cos cube x only. Love a point. So like that you can able to solve the remaining problems also. Love a point. So this is the type 5. Next we'll go for the next higher level. So that is the level number 6. So first of all, please all of you see this. So here f of x is equal to, log of root tan x. Log of root tan x. So differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Differentiate with respect to x on both sides. That means d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of log of root tan x. Log of root tan x. Therefore, this is f dash of x is equal to, f dash of x is equal to, so I had to assume this root of tan x has to be x only, but had to write in terms of the root of tan x only, but we had to assume like that. Then this is in the form of log x. What is the log x derivative? 1 by x. Therefore, this is 1 by root tan x, but whatever you have to write, so that can be written as directly, that is root of tan x. But I had to assume like that as x only. Now the internal derivative is d by dx of root of tan x. All of you catch your point? Root of tan x. Now this is equal to 1 by root tan x into, 1 by root tan x into, while you have to perform the derivative of root x. Whatever you have to assume, this one has to be x only. then this is in the form of root x. What the derivative of root x? That already I had explained the previous. D by dx of x power 1 by 2. D by dx of root x, that is equal to, how do I write? D by dx of x to the power of 1 by 2. So that is equal to 1 by 2 into x to the power of 1 by 2 minus 1. Then that is in the form of d by dx of x power n. N into x power n minus 1, that is equal to 1 by 2 into x power minus 1 by 2, that equal to minus of 1 by, sorry, that is plus 2 root x. 1 by 2 root x. I have to bring this x power minus 1 by 2 into the denominator, 1 by 2 root x. Therefore, this is 1 by 2 root of, 1 by 2 root of tan x into, again the internal derivative is d by dx of tan x. D by dx of tan x. Therefore, this is equal to here root tan x into root tan x. That is tan x only. That means this is equal to 1 by 2 into tan x. 1 by 2 into tan x into d by dx of tan x. However, right? That is secant square x only. Secant square x only. Then this is equal to 1 by 2 into, however, right? 1 by tan means there is cot x. So cot x into, so 1 by secant square x. That is only secant square x. Qualification point. So therefore, this is equal to, how do you write? This is equal to 1 by 2 into cot x, how do you write? Cos x by sin x. Cos x by sin x into, this is the simplification. Suppose if you have to left over, there is no problem at all. So there is the simplification needs to be arise, then only you can do that simplification. Therefore, this is secant square x means, how do you write? So there is cos square x, 1 by cos square x. 1 by cos square x. Therefore, this is equal to, so 1 by cos square x, 1 by cos square x, here 2 to cos x is to be cancelled. Then this is in the form of, that is equal to 1 by 2 into sin x into cos x. So 1 by 2 into sin x means, 2 sin x into cos x means, how do you write? That is 1 by sin 2x. So then this is equal to 1 by sin means, that is cosecant 2x. After simplification, we will get the values to be cosecant 2x only. Okay. Now, so I will go for the fourth sum also. I will go for the fourth sum. That is the internal derivative is there. So first of all, okay, no? Now, coming to the fourth problem. So, f of x is equal to, f of x is equal to sine of log of tan x. Sine of log of tan x. Qualification point. Differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Then this is d by dx of f of x is equal to. So d by dx of sine of log of tan x. Sine of log of tan x. Therefore, the f of x derivative is f dash of x. Please all of you keep in your mind, while you have to perform the derivative of sine function, I have to assume this total function has to be x only. Then this is in the form of sine x. Therefore, while you have to write in terms of x, directly put the value for x by log of tan x. Okay. So therefore, the sin x derivative is cos x. Therefore, cos of log of tan x. Qualification point. Cos of log of tan x into the internal derivative is d by dx of log of tan x. D by dx of log of tan x. Now, I have to perform the derivative of log of tan x. I have to assume this tan x has to be x only. Please all of you keep in your mind. While you have to perform the derivative of log of tan x, had to assume this one has to be x only. But you can write it as to be tan x. Therefore, log of tan x means 1 by tan x. This is equal to cos of log of tan x. Cos of log of tan x into d by dx of log of tan x means 1 by tan x into again d by dx of tan x. This is the internal derivative of the another function tan x. Now this is equal to cos of log of tan x, cos of log of tan x into 1 by tan x means that is cot x, cot x into d by dx of tan x means that is secant square x into secant square x. Then this is equal to, so here cot x into secant square x, cos cot x into secant square x. How I have to write cos x means that is cos x by sin x. So into secant square x means 1 by cos square x. So here cos x both are to be cancelled. Then this is equal to 1 by sin x into cos x. 1 by sin x into cos x. So in our convenience way, have to add and multiply and division with 2. Then this is in the form of 2 sin x into cos x. How we have to write 2 sin x into cos x means sin 2x. Therefore, this is equal to 2 by sin 2x. 2 by sin 2x. So then this is 2 into 1 by sin 2x. 1 by sin means, how can you write? So cosecant 2x. Cosecant 2x. In place of this, directly you have to write, this is equal to cos of log of tan x. Cos of log of tan x into, so cot x into secant square x means that is 2 into cosecant 2x. This is the total derivative of the given function. So these type of the functions are called as composite functions. Allow me to show point. So in that similar way, have to do the problem has to be, so fifth one, that is, so f of x is equal to so secant of log of, so root of 2x plus 3. This is the combination of the three functions, logarithmic function and the trigonometric function, in which the algebraic function, in which the square root is also there. Okay, therefore differentiate with respect to x on both sides. That means d by dx of f of x is equal to, so d by dx of secant of log of, so root of 2x plus 3. Application point. Then this is f dash of x is equal to. While you have to perform the derivative of secant x. What is the derivative of secant x? D by dx of secant x means secant x into tan x. So while you have to assume this one has to be x, but you can write it as to be log of square root of 2x plus 3, you can write it as directly. Okay. Therefore, here you have to know the formula for d by dx of secant x is equal to secant x into tan x. Therefore, that is equal to secant of log of, so square root of 2x plus 3 into next one, tan of log of, so square root of 2x plus 3 into the internal derivative is d by dx of log of square root of 2x plus 3. Classification point. Now this is equal to secant of log of square root of 2x plus 3 into that is tan of log of, so square root of 2x plus 3 into now we have to perform the derivative of log x. Have to assume this one has to be x. Then this is in the form of log x. What is the derivative of log x? 1 by x. Therefore, this is equal to, so this is 1 by square root of 2x plus 3 into d by dx of, so root of 2x plus 3. Root of 2x plus 3. Allow me to catch your point. Now, this is equal to secant of log of, so square root of 2x plus 3, so into tan of log of square root of 2x plus 3, so into 1 by root 2x plus 3 into 1 by root 2x plus 3 into, now this in the form of root x. What is the derivative of root x? 1 by 2 root x. That is equal to 1 by, so 2 root of 2x plus 3 into 1 by 2x plus 3 into, again 2x plus 3 derivative is 2. Directly I have to write here. nullification point. Therefore, here 2, 2 is to be cancelled, both are. So, root of 2x plus 3 into root of 2x plus 3, that can be written as 2x plus 3 only. After simplification, we will get, so the final answer is secant of log of root 2x plus 3 plus, so into tan of log of root of 2x plus 3 into 1 by 2x plus 3. This is the final answer. Well, you have to perform the derivative of secant of log of root 2x plus 3. Well, I think I should find. Now, coming to the last problem. So, seventh one is sin to the power of 4 of log tan x. Sin to the power of 4 of log tan x. So, please, all of you say this. So, seventh one, f of x is equal to sin to the power of 4 of log of tan x. Log of tan x. Let me get your point. Now, differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Now, differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Therefore, d by dx of f of x is equal to d by dx of sine to the power of 4 of log of tan x. Log of tan x. Then, in place of this, directly I have to write it as f dash of x is equal to, then I have to assume this one has to be total value is to be x. Then this is in the form of sine to the power of 4x. Then you have to assume or expect that is in terms of x power n. What is the formula for d by dx of x power n? N into x power n minus 1. Therefore, here x means sine x. So that is whole to the power of 4. N means 4. Therefore, while you have to perform the derivative of this total function, then this is in the form of d by dx of x power n. Then the formula is n into x power n minus 1. Therefore, 4 into sine to the power of 4 minus 1 means that is 3. Directly I have to write here. So, sine cube of log of tan x into d by dx of which function? D by dx of which function? Whatever I assume x, directly I have to take the derivative of that function x. So, that is d by dx of log of tan x. And if you catch your point. Now, this is equal to 4 into sine cube of log of tan x into, now this is the logarithmic function. While you have to perform the derivative of log of tan x. So the d by dx of log x is, that already you have to know the formula is 1 by x. Now I have to assume this tan x has to be x only. Therefore, so d by dx of log x means 1 by tan x into again d by dx of tan x. That is the internal derivative, d by dx of tan x. Now this is equal to 4 into sine cube of log of tan x into 1 by tan x means, that is, how do I write, cot x. So cot x into d by dx of tan x. D by dx of tan x means that is secant square x. Let me get your point. So therefore, what had to write? So the final answer is that may be getting here. So cot x into secant square x. Cot x into secant square x, that is equal to, how I have to write, cot x means that is cos x by sin x into secant square x means that is 1 by cos square x. Here cos is to be cancelled. I have to multiply and division with 2. So that is 2 by 2 into sin x into cos x. So in place of this, directly I have to write this one has to be 2 by sin 2x. So that is equal to 2 into cosecant 2x. In place of this, cot x into secant square, that may be arises. In place of that, directly I have to write 2 into cosecant 2x. Therefore, this is equal to 4 into sine cube of log of tan x into, directly I have to write, that is 2. 2 into cosecant 2x. So after that, we have to multiply with 2. 2 into 2 means, that is 2 into 4 means 8. 8 into sine cube of log of tan x into cosecant 2x. Likewise, that may be obtained the final answer. So likewise, you have to complete all the remaining problems, whatever that may be available in your practice session. Okay, thank you. Today onwards, we have to discuss the concept of the differentiation of the composite functions. how you can easily perform the derivatives. These concepts you have to see in the next class onwards. We'll see for the higher level, the next level we'll go for the differentiation. Thank you. Thank you for kindly listening.